He's actually a really good rapper. It's actually surprising how good he is. My name is Strange Boy. I'm at Body and Soul about to perform. This is District's 50 for 50 with Hennessy. My favourite rapper is Big L. His voice, I think his voice is iconic, and I think his punchlines and bars and flows way ahead of his time. I think the most overrated rap, it would probably be Drake, but I also think he's one of the GOATs as well, but I think people hype him up a bit too much sometimes, you know what I mean? But I think the most underrated rapper is Tyler, the Creator, I think. I think that man has people be sleeping on him, you know? But then when he dropped his newer stuff, I think it just took elevated him to a different type of levels, you know? He be rapping these days, like so. My wedding song, probably Kitty Callan, It's Been a Long, Long Time. Never thought that you would be standing here so close to me. Unreal. Very romantic. My earliest hip-hop memory is when my brother played me, like, Pinko Is My Name Is by Eminem. And I was like, what's this, like, do you know what I mean? So, hi, my name is And then I got into it from then. I got in through Eminem, and I was a big fan of Akon at the time, so. East Coast. It's where it started. Do you know what I mean? You've Big L, you've Nas, just of all OGs, Biggie. Do you know, Tupac is really from the East Coast, even though he claims West Coast, but still, best rappers definitely of all time. 100%. The best use of a sample is the one they had on Money Trees. What was it? Beach House. They kind of flipped it and then put on Money Trees. Amazing, genius. I love that. Yeah, I think they reversed it and slowed it down or something like that, man. Yeah, it was amazing. My favourite music video would probably be Pamela Anderson. I think Pamela Anderson's in it. What's the name of that video, man? We Made You, is it? Where the Was That Made You is definitely my favourite music video of all time, 100%. My first hip-hop record was Stillmatic by Nas, yeah. That was the first, Stillmatic was the first one I bought, and then I think I bought a few albums by Tupac and a few by Biggie, but I think it was Stillmatic, yeah. Biggie released Ready to Die. I think that was the most iconic moment when he released Ready to Die, because in my opinion, that's the best hip-hop album of all time in my eyes, so. It's not one bad, every track is a classic. You know, and cause it's Biggie, like his voice was iconic, bars, punchlines, just untouchable. Probably Tyler the Creator, to be honest, definitely the best dressed rapper. I watched a video of him there recently, all the stuff he collects. Mad man, he's into all that stuff, but it's yeah, it's very good aesthetic. It comes through on his music as well, you know, when he makes tunes. I'd love to have a drink with old Dirty Bastard from Wu-Tang. Lovely. Go on the lash with him for a night, it'd be amazing. I just talk absolute shit with him. Just have the crack, get wasted, you know what I mean? We're probably smashing up a car or something, man, or just like outside Supermax eating a chicken curry or some shit like that. You know, I don't even know. I probably wouldn't even be able to remember the next day anyway, whatever we would be getting up to. Best gig I've ever been to was Kendrick Lamar there last year. Because I don't get to much gigs, unfortunately, but I grew up listening to him basically, you know, and it was such a shock seeing him live in person. I was like, what? Yeah, it was amazing. I was kind of, didn't really know how to react. It was deadly. I have no guilty pleasure at all. I listen to Vanilla Ice, do you know what I mean, when I can, like just whoever, like, do you know, if you're afraid to say to someone what you listen to, I don't know, I don't understand that. I listen to anyone and everyone really, so none, absolutely no guilty pleasures. I would say Biggie Ready to Die as well, with the baby on the front of it. I'd say that one. That was definitely the most iconic in my eyes, yeah. Very simplistic, but I don't know, I just spoke volumes, I suppose, you know. It was very good, like, sticks out. Like. It took me a while to warm up the little Wayne, because one of my friends was hyping him up to me for years, and I didn't really understand it. But then I heard a few of his tunes, and I was, you know, he started growing on me, and then I heard Mona Lisa. And then it just kind of blew my mind with that. And then I just listened to his whole discography. It was crazy. You'll only know that it's gone when you check it. Then your first thought is to start second guessing. She said what's wrong, he say nothing, keep resting. She said what's missing, how you know something missing. He's actually a really good rapper. It's actually surprising how good he is. Some songs then are just mind-blowingly good. It's insane, you know. So definitely Lil Wayne. I'm Strange Boy, about to go on stage at Body and Soul. This has been 50-50 with District and Hennessy.